Now leave in the comments how much you love me. Exactly. So today we're talking about Warframe reviews because I'm doing a review on the Switch port for Warframe. They got some good things to say, got some bad things to say. Obviously, it's a review. Or is that so obvious? That's what we're talking about. Been watching a lot of reviews on Warframe ever since I got my Switch, and people were getting access to Warframe. I was excited to play it on the Switch, and I wanted to see what people would say about it. I wanted to glean a little bit of information because, you know, I'm new to the Switch. I don't really know how to control or what's the best way to play certain games. It's kind of clunky. It's awkward overall for someone who's new to it. Even though I play mobile games and I play with a lot of weird controllers like Steam controller on games maybe I shouldn't, still, it's kind of a learning process, and Warframe is a game I'm always jumping back into, even though I played from the beginning. Yeah, I dip my toe in every once in a while, so maybe I can get some information that would get me, you know, up and running as fast as possible. You know, give me your thoughts, give me your feelings, man. Let me know what your process is, and maybe I can kind of follow suit or something. But here's the thing, guys, is I'm looking at these reviews, and I'm trying to glean some any real information on the gameplay, and basically, I'm getting none. You know, these big channels, they're just all regurgitating the exact same stuff. You know, the same stuff you can read on the website or the back of the box, and this is something that I complain about a lot, especially with IGN. Is that they make like 4 minute commercials, and then the last minute there might be a dash of a review. Really, they just kind of throw out numbers. They'll give you a score in the end, say if you should buy it or shouldn't. I guess technically that makes it a review, but the vast majority of the content in these videos from all these influencers and these commercial, you know, channels, it's just it is just influencing. It is just a commercial. It is just a regurgitation of facts, and facts are not a review. You know, a lot of people would love to, you know, go into my videos and say, dude, your video is just your opinion. And I'm like, fucking duh, it's a review. You know, if you look at any other medium's reviews, that's what it is. Go to Jeremy Johns for movie reviews. You see how expressive he can be. It's almost artistic how that guy stands in front of a camera and basically does, like, I don't know, to me, it's almost as entertaining as actually watching the movie. I mean, it's only like 5 minutes or whatever, but dude is just out there and he's throwing his voice. He's moving around. He's letting you know how he felt during the movie. You know, he reviews different plot points. He's talking about specific actors and things. Or what about Anthony Fantano, right? The internet's busiest music nerd or whatever, dude. That guy, oh my God, he's actually like so poetic when it comes to how descriptive he is trying to talk about the songs, which, I mean, he can't play because of copyright, I guess. But no, he's really good at expressing himself, and that kind of poetry is the kind that I want to hear. But you go to game reviews, and the kind of poetry you get is just sugar-coated, really kind of just cursive. You know, they're basically saying the same words, but just kind of editing it in a video so it looks real pretty, real good-like. I mean, it's just actually kind of disgusting and gross to me. It is literally gross because I'm seeing it too much. It's every single commercial channel, and I mean, obviously it's going to be like influencers of Warframe, you know, their reviews of Warframe are going to be a lot less biting and teethy, sure, because they're influencers, that's their livelihood, so you can kind of see their bias. But that's what I'm kind of making this video for, to tell you guys, as an influencer, I'm telling you, there is absolutely an influence for me to influence you. Warframe is a hype game, right? Which is why I'm using it as an example right here. It's hyped. Everyone knows it's hyped. Everyone knows it's going to be free views, free engagement. People are going to talk about the comment, you know, in the comments, like, oh my God, I love Warframe. I have 10,000 hours. You know, it's so cool that this is coming to Switch. Whoa. You know that it's going to get views. It's going to make you money. It's such a safe bet. You know, all you got to do is basically just say what you know, everyone else wants you to say. And that's the problem, is all these content creators are put into this box of safety, and that's what they do. So I'm not saying they're using all the same footage or saying the exact same words, but almost. It is their own footage and their own words. It just is nearly identical. Nothing is really truly expressive. And that's the problem, is that Warframe specifically is a very expressive game, if it's not for the customization, the literal controls, and then the Switch itself is very expressive in how you play with it, what you do with it. Now, it's no mouse and keyboard, and it's really clunky, but, like, you can still play in a lot of different ways, which is why I was watching these fucking reviews, because this game is complex, and there's a lot to do, and the Switch is really cool. Like, how am I supposed to set my settings, you know? Is anybody going to talk about that? How they set the gyro controls? Are we even going to mention the fact that you can change around button key bindings, but they're not fully inclusive? Like, you can only do certain mappings? Are we not going to talk about this? There's some very strict, very specific things that can make or break gameplay for some people. You know, what happened to the total biscuit line of thought where we got to look at the options menu, or are you just reserving that for like Digital Foundry, right? Is that an analysis video? Sky, an analysis video isn't a review. Motherflucker. I am telling you right now that a review and analysis, those are synonyms, my dudes. So you need to, as a reviewer, analyze the gameplay, but then describe it with your own thoughts and feelings, how you interacted with it. And I'm not getting any sort of interaction whatsoever. These guys are just like, it's Warframe, it's ninjas in space, and now you can play on the Switch, and it runs at 30 FPS, and it has dynamic resolution scaling, and it's like, it's pretty good. Like, it's a good part. But like, what? Okay, yeah, I mean, we kind of expected that, right? From the company porting it to digital extremes. I mean, it is fucking Warframe. Like, we kind of expected it to be kind of okay, right? So now that you let us know it's okay for 5 minutes and, you know, repeating words, can you, like, actually tell us what the gameplay was like? I mean, really, the only people actually giving me any real information are these super small YouTubers, you know, the ones that have, you know, no actual, probably actually no money, probably no monetization whatsoever. I mean, like 800 subscribers. Yeah, I don't even think you can monetize. I think you need 1,000 subscribers. I don't fucking know. Anyways, so these guys are just gamers, right? They're just playing the game. They're just literally talking about how they're playing the game, what that experience is like. That is the most informative shits ever. Like, there was even a guy who has 800 subscribers. This dude freaking knew stuff that I didn't even know. I was fantastic. I was so blown away because I was playing solo. So he was talking about the netcode, and you know, he really opened my eyes. And that's what a good review does, man. A good review isn't just, you know, showing off pretty clips, right? It's not just talking pretty words. It's, you know, which is something that happens a lot. If I can name drop, ACG Angry Centaur Gaming is somebody who is accredited as being a very good reviewer. However, the vast majority of his videos are just kind of sped through. He's just kind of talking through a script, which is mostly just jokes. Yeah, it's not really a lot of criticism. I mean, technically their reviews, maybe not the worst, but I'm just saying, there could be a lot better out there. I'm seeing a lot of smaller YouTubers who aren't getting shared, who aren't really known, and they're just amazing because they're the gamers. They're the players, and those are the people that you should be listening to, you know, reviews from. But anyways, these commercial guys, you know, they're playing the Warframe game on YouTube, which is basically Warframe is hype. Anytime there's a new expansion or anything, you gotta shit out a video as fast as possible. So these guys are doing videos, and you know, maybe they got the game early or something, but still, man, they're doing videos so freaking quickly, and they're not talking about any in-depth content whatsoever. Now, I know Warframe, it can be very easy. The skill floor is pretty low. Like, it can actually be mind-numbingly easy and dumb. But there is, like, a skill ceiling. And the entire point of Warframe is efficiency and trying to peak at that skill ceiling. You know, get the grind, you know, getting all the customization, getting as powerful as possible, and trying to wield that power as well as possible. And nobody gave me the inclination that they had any idea what they were doing. Like, seriously, even a lot of these influencers, really, I don't think they really spent time to really try to get good with the Switch controls, with the gyro controls, and really play the game proper. Because, I mean, I'm sitting here and I'm getting better every single second, and I'm seeing the real potential and fun in the game, but that's only after getting around the clunkiness, the awkwardness, and the shit that nobody wanted to talk about. So there's a lot of good that's behind a lot of clunkiness, these speed bumps you have to get over. And I love using that analogy whenever it comes to whenever I start talking about negative reviews. But like, I am having fun with Warframe on the Switch, which is weird because I was kind of hate playing it for a while. But like, watching all these reviews and seeing my experience and how I know I normally have a unique perspective, but I have a really open mind. I have a very wide perspective. Which you guys might not always get because I do videos episodically on specific perspectives, but regardless, anyways, I digress. I am looking at all these reviews, and even if they agreed with me or not, I just think it's really gross that so many of these videos are in the same format, they say the same words, they're done in the same voice style, you know, like, so even if I didn't really believe in their integrity as a reviewer, artistically, there's fucking nothing there. Yeah, I guess you got some cool game capture, which is a job. Video game capture artist is a job. So, you know, you got some cool footage, which isn't hard because Warframe looks amazing. And you threw it together and somebody wrote a script for you to just monotonically, you know, speak over it. That's it. That's what I'm seeing. And I want to see more videos in a voice that's kind of like mine, or like old Total Biscuit, rest in peace. Or, you know, a lot of these younger YouTubers that have so much emotion and they love the game they play, or they hate it. And they're just expressive about it. And I want to see more stuff like that. And the thing is I don't think we're going to get more of that. I think people are going to try and they're not going to grow. I think that maybe some big channels used to do that and they're going to stop doing it. Or, you know, every once in a while, channel will be like, okay, let's you know, let's do this review. This is a really passionate game. Let's be passionate about it. So, you know, they have a really good fan base. So let's be a little bit more critical. No, I'm just going to get a ton of dislikes. It's not going to get shared as much. And somebody's probably going to get fired. And so then they'll be like, okay, we'll play it safe from now on. That's what I think is happening and will continue to happen at a more exponential rate. And I'm really scared because, you know, just looking at this big example of, yes, it is a good port, but it is not a great port. Don't let anybody tell you it's a great port. And the thing is everybody's going to tell you it's a great port. It's not. If StarCraft 2 was ported to mobile, it would not be a fucking great port. There is just no way, right? There's just no way. Warframe, come on. It's a good port, but it is not great. There is a lot of issues. And even then, there is some really cool stuff going on with it that nobody's talking about. Like, I mean, seriously, the gyro controls are actually kind of amazing in handheld mode, but whatever. Almost nobody's using footage of them playing it in handheld mode. What the hell, man? Like, actually, seriously, if somebody can find me footage of somebody actually playing it in handheld mode and actually talking about it, I would love to see it. Because that's what I'm planning for my review. Because you know what? I'm not just some random shill, whether you want to believe that or not. I'm not just some random guy trying to ride hype waves. I mean, I'm playing the YouTube game just like you guys, but I really do try to have integrity. But that involves, you know, a little bit of nuance. There is a lot of, there's a lot of different kind of perspectives. So I try to cover all of it, whether you agree with it or not. The thing is that, it's my opinion. And I got a big opinion. I got a lot of big opinions. Got a lot of different big opinions. And that's why I'm doing the videos and talking and ranting at them. So if you appreciate that emotion, you appreciate my voice. Thanks for watching, I guess is all I can say. And, you know, if you do disagree or agree, I would love to know your elucidations. I want to know your explanations down in the comments below, how you feel, because that does influence me. Obviously, I just admitted here for, 14 minutes that I watch other people's reviews. I read every single comment, and so I want to know. You guys, the friends and family, do also influence me, you know, and it's back and forth. I influence you, and that's how I appreciate it. It's not one way, like these other commercial channels. And so I guess in closing, what I want to say is, if you are going to look up reviews, if you are going to look up, you know, new games or tips and tricks videos, honestly, guys, fuck the big people. You know, at this point, just fuck them, right? Like, I hate to be that person because I never believed in this. But like, you know, those people who are like, yo, the best Chinese food comes from that, you know, down that alleyway, the hole in the wall. That's the best shit. You know what, guys? It might actually just be the best shit. It's the most real, honest shit out there. So, yeah, I mean, I guess that's all I can say.